My pantry is adjacent from the garage door. So when we come into the house, this is normally where we stand and put all of our stuff. So over here in the, like, the little butler's pantry area, this is where we put my purse, or his wallet, all that good stuff. So that's where we put everything. But right here is the pantry, and you guys can see that I have it decorated for the Halloween holiday. So let's go ahead and take a peek inside of my pantry, and I'm gonna show you guys how I have organized my pantry since moving in here.
So when you first open the door, this is exactly what you see in the pantry. And you see the big sign right above there that says pantry. I absolutely love it.
So up here on the top shelves, you guys can see this is where I have stored all of my tiered trays. And I absolutely love being able to store them up here because it actually gives me an idea of what tier trays I have and which ones I would like to use at any given time. Then over here is my little roaster pan, and then I kind of have like a basket set on top of there because I really didn't have another place to put that. So that's where that is sitting for now. But I just thought this was such an awesome area for me to be able to store all of my tiered trays. I actually have a little dish back there as well that I needed to just kind of tuck away in a corner somewhere, and that was perfect. And then right over here is where I have some of the little grilling things, and then my charcuterie board is right there as well. I probably pronounced that wrong, but you guys know what I'm trying to say. Then over here, you guys will see the mug collection that we have, all from Disney and Universal. And I absolutely love that this mug thing hangs in here because it just gives so much room, and it just makes the mugs be able to, I mean, you can see the mugs a lot better in here, obviously, and be able to choose from them as well. Okay, so going down here on this level, this is right underneath all of the tiered trays. So over here I have flour and sugar. I have these in the little containers. Don't know why that lid's not out, because it's full. I can't close it all the way. Anyways, I have all of this stuff in here. This is the flour that I will actually take with me when I am baking something. This is just extra flour, extra sugar. I actually laid down this plastic, or I don't even know what this stuff is, but it's just like a counter liner. Absolutely love it. I just wanted to add this extra protection on here so these don't get scratched up. So I just put those in here, which is really, really nice. And I actually secured them down in the corners and in spots throughout this counter liner with double-sided tape. Okay, so you guys can see that I have all of my stuff organized as well, and all of the labels on here. You guys can see I have powdered sugar, cornmeal, cornstarch, baking soda, baking powder, panko breadcrumbs, all of the salts, sea salt, salt, kosher salt, etc., etc., etc. And then back there I have like pasta and all of my noodles and stuff back there that I would use to cook with, spaghetti, macaroni and cheese, etc. And then right here is some more, I think this is like white cornmeal, I believe. I don't have a little sticker on it because they didn't have one that said white cornmeal. This one has chocolate chips, brown sugar, regular cornmeal, white rice and brown rice. And then this one has some of Brian's little crackers that he likes to eat, which are the peanut butter crackers. And then these are just regular Ritz crackers. And then behind it are the little Nutri-Bars that we like to eat, the Nature Valley wafer bars. So we have those in there. And then right here I have all of my tea. And then here I have all of like my seasoning packets in here. And then we have this popcorn, which is microwavable popcorn. And even though we have a popcorn machine upstairs, we've always had popcorn at the other house. This is just kind of, we brought this from the other house. But we actually like to bring these when we do travel, because if the room happens to have a microwave in it, then we can actually pop some popcorn. So I do tend to throw these in our travel bag from time to time. This is our oatmeal, quick instant oatmeal that we like to eat. And then we have malt meal over here, then graham crackers right there. And then this is my big tea pouches that I like to use for my tea maker. Two boxes of Cheerios back there because I love just having dry Honey Nut Cheerios, and then some Cheater Pop-Tarts. And then right here I have some more spaghetti because it just wouldn't fit back there in the corner. And now we are below
underneath, this is the other shelf. So back here I have rice and risotto and couscous back there. I have some macaroni and cheese right here. I have taco shells and this one, wheat thins. And this is where I start all of my canned foods. And you guys can see it kind of goes all the way around into that little section over there. And then over here I started with all like the beans. And then I went with like chili beans, black-eyed peas, etc., butter beans, garbanzo beans, and then like tomato sauces and stuff back there in the corner. And then back there in the corner is just like extra stuff. Pepperoncinis, jalapenos, and salsa is back there. I have my Rotel right here. And then these are more of my vegetable, canned vegetables. We're talking like sweet corn and whole kernel corn, peas and collard greens and green beans. This is soups, tomato, French onion, clam chowder, bean and bacon. You get the gist. I have tuna and chicken right here and then some crab meat there for my dips. And then starting back here, I have chips that I leave back here in this basket. And then those are some ones that haven't been opened yet. And then this is coffee. And then back there is for my little, that little cafe dolce thing that I like to use in the wintertime. So that's all extra coffees there. This is a set that I use for when I'm making like my hot cocoa bar. I just fill these up with like hot cocoa, sprinkles, etc. I have two empty glass jars back there that they're not being used for anything right now, so they're just a perfect spot for those. This is where I've kind of been putting some of our like Halloween snacks that we like to have around the house. These just happen to be popcorn balls at the time. And then right here is where I keep all of our like tortilla shells and stuff like that. And then down here is more extra stuff, so like tomato sauce and marinara sauce. This is like Hershey's syrup, Nestle's Quick, hot cocoa mix, condensed milk, and more cocoa mix, and then like cake stuff. This is for cookies that is completely empty. And then I have some juice here that I like just to leave here. This is just extra juice. This is just gluten-free panini or penne rigate. I have no clue how to pronounce it. And then some extra stuff down here, and then extra Cokes, and then a drink. And then down here is all of my other extra stuff that I like to have on hand. Garbage bags, tea, this is my Keurig stuff, extra pretzels. This stuff is for the babies when they come visit. I need to put that sauce back down there. This sauce actually can go down here. These are actually for when the babies come, when Lucas and Parker do come visit or whatever. I will have some like little lunch for them here if they need that. And then beef broth and chicken broth, extra mayonnaise and ketchup. There's honey. There is salad dressings there, soy sauce, extra stuff like that, Tabasco. We have cake mixes down here, extra wheat thins, extra malt meal. All this stuff is like party stuff. So I have crackers, and then all the red cups and stuff are back there, extra plastic silverware. All that stuff is back there in that corner. And then I have powdered sugar right here, and extra sugar, and then vegetable shortening. And then my classic croutons are back there as well for salads. And then this is just has extra towels in it, but those are like seasonal towels. And then underneath here is where I store all of my like bags and coolers that I will carry back and forth to say like the neighbor's house or my parents' house or whatnot. And then that's our little toaster back there that we always carry with us. I have drinks right here that I keep underneath here. And then because we really don't have a place to keep our shoes out here so nobody trips over them, I need to see that 7-Up that needs to come in here. We keep just like tennis shoes and stuff down here and just shoes that we need to grab on the go when we're gonna like walk outside or something. So I just thought that they were perfect, convenient little spots for them right there. And then this is where I will put like potatoes and onions. You guys can see I have onions there, but then I'll put potatoes there too. Maybe some extra apples or whatever the case may be, but I just set that stuff there. And then up here, that's where I have all of my other stuff. My smokeless grill, my buffet server, my Instapots, all that stuff is stored up there. My griddle, you can see right there.
My little pokers for the s'mores, all that is right there. And then right here is where I will have all of my extra paper towels. Brian actually hung this up for me a couple of weeks ago because I kind of knew I wanted another shelf there because I needed to put my paper towels somewhere and my extra paper plates. So that's where we put all that. And then I have my Hershey s'mores thing right there so we can go out and, you know, roast marshmallows and stuff like that once we get the burn pit built. Then I have these clipped on here, just extra bags for like trash or stuff that I put in my car. I keep these in my car for trash, etc., etc. I carry them upstairs for trash, put them in our garbage bags in our bathrooms for trash. And then over here in this corner, I have my stool that I like to use to climb up on things. And then down here, this is the same thing that I had in the other house. This just kind of has all of our like koozies and stuff in it. I have cupcake liners in here, cookie presses, etc., etc. And that's the same thing kind of going all the way down in this little container, more of those little cookie things. And then over here is where I keep my water cooler. And obviously we needed to make sure that this was up high enough so when Brian put the water cooler, or when he put the water container on the water cooler, it didn't hit that. So we worked that out perfectly. And so this is where we have the water cooler. We had a guy come in and put an extra plug back there because there was no electricity as far as plugging things in here. And I knew this would be a perfect spot for my water cooler, so they went ahead and put a plug in there for me. And then behind the door of the pantry is where I hang all of my brooms and my Swiffer and whatnot. So that stuff goes right there. And again, it's just perfect. It worked out so nice.